Hello friends, welcome to Science Talk. I am your host, Jim Massa. In continuing bringing to you more reports, more research, looking at food risks as the planet warms, I have a study that was published in the journal Science Advances. And basically what the study informs is that more than a third of world plants are so rare they face extinction. In a warmer world, that would leave supplies of food at risk. Botanists have made a new census of terrestrial plants, and they have discovered that nearly 40% of them are rare, extremely rare. This may put food at risk. I'll explain why in a bit. A second team of researchers in a separate study has established that some of these rare or vanishing species could include, and this is where it's critical, the wild relative of some of, of the planet's most popular vegetables. So why do these studies matter? The first underlies yet another reason for new and determined conservation strategies to preserve, basically preserve the biodiversity that's already under pressure from human activity encroaching on habitats. You guys know what the... So on. The second study is simply a matter of, you know, finding where the where your food is going to come from. Many rare plants are survivors with the resources to adapt to change. In a fast-changing world, crop breeders may need to go back to the wild relatives to look for the genes that will keep the commercial plants, carrots, pumpkins, peppers, whatever, in the stores. So if these plants go extinct, we may not be able to genetically fix or breed the desired quality because we don't have a reference point. So U.S. scientists and international colleagues in this Science Advance article, they worked for 10 years, compiled 20 million observational records to establish a simple plant census. Forests, grasslands, scrublands, tundra, and swamps of the wild world are home to about 435,000 unique plant species. Of that number, 36.5% are exceedingly rare. By this, researchers mean that these species have been observed and recorded no more than five times in the last 300 years of systematic botanical research. Brian Enquist of the University of Arizona, who led this particular consortium, states that according to ecological and evolutionary theory, we'd expect many species to be rare, but the actual observed number we found was pretty startling. There are many more rare species than we expected. These rare species were most likely to be clustered in what ecologists call hotspots. Northern Andes in South America, Costa Rica, South Africa, Madagascar, Southeast Asia. What these places have in common is that over millions of years, they have maintained stable climates. And as the glaciers retreated at the end of the last ice age, these tropical mountains and valleys provided refuge for biodiversity. These survivors may not have a stable future because of ever-increasing CO2 levels and ever-increasing temperature levels, as well as humans' encroachment. Now, you can say, what's the big deal? Okay, well, we already said that a lot of farmers, a lot of agriculturalists will go back to the wild relatives of the commercially important crops to gain important genetic information and genetic material. And of course, humans depend on the natural world for biodiversity. Plants, fungi, mammals, fish, birds, amphibs, amphibians, reptiles, etc. You know the litany. But also, especially from the tropics, a lot of plants, while we may not be able to ingest them, there's a lot of potential medicines to be found with these tropical plants. We lose these plants, we don't know what potential medical cure or treatment they could provide. Very, very serious. As well as fuels, fabrics, textiles, you know, the rubber tree gives us rubber, right? It gives us latex, as an example. New research in the journal Plants, People, Planet confirms again that many of the wild ancestors and cousins of the crops that feed billions of people are at risk. And these wild relatives, which have survived climate shifts over millions of years, represent a vital resource for plant breeders who are trying to cope with the global heating. And of course, like everything else, it's the rate of change. The latest study confirms 65% of wild pumpkins, as an example, more than 95% of wild chili peppers are not formally preserved in any gene banks protected by conservation scientists. Wild relatives of crops are one of the key tools used to breed crops adapted to hotter, colder, drier, wetter, saltier, other difficult conditions, said Colin Curry of the International Center for Tropical Agriculture. He continues, but they are impacted by habitat destruction, over harvesting, climate change, pollution, invasive species, and other factors. Some are sure to disappear from the natural habitats without urgent action. Dr. Curry and his colleagues have prepared a series of detailed maps of the range and distribution of the wild relatives of a range of important food species. The aim is to focus on the most effective kinds of protection so that food for the future can be ensured. If they disappear, they are gone, said Dr. Curry. Extinction is forever, which is a loss not only in terms of evolution and persistence on the planet, but also a loss to the future of our food. For humans to consistently think that we are separate from nature is utter stupidity. We are part of the ecosystem. We have to preserve the ecosystem. Because preserving the ecosystem is preserving ourselves. And right now, we're doing a shitty job of preserving the ecosystem. We are thus ensuring our own demise as a species, our own extinction. Thank you for your time. Hello, folks. This is Jim here with Science Talk, asking you to please subscribe to my channel and to inform others of my channel and of the work that I do. Please share to social media platforms that you use. Also, as a reminder, don't forget to click the bell so that you know when I load up more videos. Finally, I ask that you support the work that I do by becoming a patron at patreon.com. Details in the description box below. Thank you for your support.